for me, that's kind of like, okay, so what do we do? What do I want to do once we achieve freedom? I'll choose one of the 18,000 flavors. But for me, the overarching umbrella for all of this is voluntaryism, which is a pretty basic ethical principle that I think corresponds to what I perceive to be natural law, which is pretty basic ideas. Basically, don't aggress upon peaceful people, and don't try to violate their body, their property, against their will. I mean, things that most people, I think most reasonable people would agree with in principle, in general, and you can come up with a million different situations. Well, what if this happens? And what about this? And what about that? And that's the kind of thing where you have to work out in actuality. There's no way to have some magical principle that's going to suit every situation. But the voluntarist idea is, once we have that established, then you go off and you choose your flavor of community that you want to form with like-minded people. And it's all about voluntary association. People are free to join, people are free to leave. No one has to abide by your particular vision of the world. And that, for me, is enough. I'm happy for there to be communists and socialists and capitalists and everything else. Everyone who wants to try whatever way of living is fine. And sometimes I say, let the best idea win, as if it's a competition. But in fact, it's not a competition. I mean, who am I to say what's a win for someone else? I don't know. And you don't know what's a win for me. I get to choose what I want to do. You get to choose what you want to do. Let's go off and live. And if I see the way that you guys are living and I think that looks good for me, well, maybe I'll join you. And maybe vice versa. But that's the ultimate umbrella for the vision that I have for anarchy.
How do we get to that? How does that work? What does that look like?
Yeah, in fact, as always, the devil's in the details. That's the vision, but moving from this current reality to that reality is extremely difficult, because it's like if you're playing a game, and you're playing a game of Monopoly or whatever it is, and halfway through the game, somebody's clearly winning, somebody's clearly losing, and then you say, okay, all right, let's change the rules, let's change the game. In fact, you know, play however you want. In fact, you can do anything you want with your money, and I'll do anything I want with my money, and there you go, happiness, right? But wait, no, now we're starting on an extremely unlevel playing field, and so of course this person is going to be able to function better, and this person is going to be at a lower rate. So in the same way, if we have governments and policies and rules and the system as it exists today with the corporations and all of this, and then suddenly you say, okay, now you're all free to do whatever you want. Well, obviously the people who are far ahead in the game are going to benefit. So there is a real problem of how you deal with that. To simply, okay, now everybody's free. If you simply declare that, there are going to be clear winners and losers based on nothing other than the starting point for that game. My vision for how it actually unfolds, that the state and the corporatocracy that exists today gets, I wouldn't say dismantled. In fact, it's very important what words we use here. If I say dismantled or overturned or blown up or whatever, those all come with their own ideas of how we get from here to there. But in fact, I would say replaced or overgrown or disposed of. And the vision or the model that I would have in mind for that is essentially the idea that technology tends to change the manner in which we relate to each other and the things that are possible for us to do. And so you have examples that we can see and we have seen in the past decade and will no doubt see much more of disruptive technologies coming along to completely obliterate old models of doing things. The obvious examples, the Airbnbs and the Ubers and the Lyfts and what have you, that are destroying industries that have existed and functioned for a very long time under certain ideas and guidelines, have almost completely been replaced now. And there
it
wasn't
happened like that. It wasn't like
exactly. There was no revolution, people marching in the streets. There was no top-down control. We're now going to make everyone use this form of getting around the town. No, people just saw, hey, that's a good idea, that's really easy. And the trick to it was replacing this heavily regulated and structured and licensed industry like the taxis, which is just a ripoff in so many different ways, for the taxi drivers as well as the the passengers. It wasn't a good system.
It was $1 million to get a taxi license in New York.
Exactly right. And why? Why? Why on earth? Oh, because it's heavily regulated. There's a sort of artificial monopoly placed on it. Someone came along and said, let's replace that artificial monopoly. We have the physical, we have the technology to make it as simple as pushing a little button and suddenly you've got someone who has a ride, sharing the ride. That's the idea. And people are going to quibble about Uber or Lyft or Airbnb or the specific examples of this, but that's forest for the trees kind of stuff. No, the bigger picture here is technology comes along and completely overturns the ways that people interact with each other. It's the technology that's sort of driving that. Or at least, no, I wouldn't say the technology is driving that. I'd say we human beings want connection with other people. We want to facilitate those connections in the easiest way possible. In times past, it was difficult if all you have is a physical phone. You got to phone the taxi and well, who am I going to phone for a ride? I don't know anyone in this town. Well, there's a taxi company. That's the way you would do it. But now the technology has made those individual connections easier. So that's what we do because we're human beings and we want that connection. And as that progresses, it will overturn everything. I mean, every industry is open to that form of revolution, if you want to call it that. And that's the way I envision this going, not political action, voting for someone who, into office who's going to change the system or something like that. It's not top down, it's bottom up.